in 39 fights. Also impressive, he fought current WBC super flyweight champion Christian Mijares to a draw. Maldonado 4-0 with three knockouts since the loss to Darchinian, although limited opposition. Yet, Al, this a gritty, battle-tested nine-year pro who shouldn't be taken lightly.
In the dictionary, next to solid pro is definitely his picture. And what's more, he has a complete bag of tricks that he brings into this fight. We talked about the switching. He is a very solid fighter, and any letdown by Donaire will not serve him well.
Maldonado, one of nine children, his father a laborer in the fields, and up until recently, about 8 months ago, in fact, Luis was a waiter and a busboy at a restaurant in Mexicali to help support his wife and four-year-old daughter, but now he is 100% devoted to the sport of boxing. They call him the Filipino Flash, the very affable, calm, composed Nonito Donaire, who returns to the same state in which he dethroned previously unbeaten and seemingly impenetrable Victor Darchinian in stunning fashion, the explosive left hook in round five. Donaire coming from virtually nowhere tonight. This young man wants to prove that he is truly an emerging presence, Al, that his performance in July was indeed no fluke, and that he is by no means a one-hit wonder.
You know, the great boxing trainer and commentator Gil Clancy often said that most fighters, when they win a championship, improve by about 20%. But there is also the matter in Donaire to consider that trip that they referred to where he went to the Philippines. Maybe some people think that all that adulation could be a distraction for him.
And in that whirlwind tour, he was honored, as he talked about with Jim Gray, by a big parade in the Philippines, feted by government officials and fans, even met with the Filipino president, as you heard him talking about so glowingly. But now it's back to business. He looks to extend his win streak to 18 in a row, has not lost since 01 in his second professional fight. Let's check the numbers as we go to the tail of the tape here at Foxwoods. Donaire turned 25 just 2 weeks ago, 4 years younger than Maldonado, the champion with the slight edge in height and reach. And at yesterday's weigh-in, both came in under the 112-pound limit by 1 pound. And the key unified rules, there's no standing eight count, no three knockdown rule. A fighter can't be saved by the bell in any round. If an accidental headbutt causes the fight to end within four, it's a no decision. After four rounds, they go to the cards. If a punch causes a cut, the injured fighter cannot continue. He loses by TKO. So here at Foxwoods in Connecticut, we are getting ready for Nonito Donaire versus Luis Maldonado for the IBF Flyweight Championship. Let's get the formal introductions from our ring announcer, Jimmy Lennon Jr.
Ladies and gentlemen, a very good evening to you and welcome to Foxwoods Resort and Casino here in Mashantucket, Connecticut, as we have a big night of action in store for you. And at this time, we present the first of our world title attractions, and it's all brought to you by Gary Shaw Productions in association with Foxwoods and Showtime. This bout coming away is sanctioned by the IBF, President Marion Mohammed, Supervisor Daryl Peoples, and the IBO, President Ed Levine, Supervisor Dr. Jason Levine, along with the Mashantucket Pequot Athletic Commission. Introducing our three judges scoring this bout from ringside, from Providence, Rhode Island, Clark Sammartino, from West Hartford, Connecticut, George Smith, and from Litchfield, Connecticut, Don Trella. And introducing our third man of the ring, the referee in charge of this bout, Charlie Dwyer. All right, fans, here we go. 12 rounds of boxing for the IBF Flyweight Championship of the World. Introducing to you first the challenger. On my right, he is fighting out of the blue corner, wearing red, white, and green trunks. He hails from Mexicali, Baja California, Mexico. He weighed in at 111 pounds with a record of 37 wins, one defeat, and one draw. He has 28 wins coming by way of knockout. Tonight he is making his second attempt at a world title. He is currently ranked number 4 in the world by the IBF. Please welcome the challenger, Luis Titi Maldonado. Opponent across the ring on my left, the defending world champion, fighting out of the red corner, wearing red trunks with white trim, fighting out of San Leandro, California, by way of General Santos City in the Philippines. He weighed in the same as his opponent, 111 pounds. His record, 18 wins, one defeat, 11 wins coming by way of knockout. Tonight, ladies and gentlemen, he is making the first defense of his title. Please welcome the IBF flyweight champion of the world, known as the Filipino Flash, introducing Nonito Donaire. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, 12 rounds of boxing scheduled. Our referee in charge now to give instructions, Charlie Dwyer.
Gentlemen, you both know the rules. Let's have a good, clean fight. Obey my commands at all times. Shake hands. Good luck. Buena suerte.
We get our triple header underway with the IBF Flyweight Championship. Can Nonito Donaire build on his stirring win just 5 months ago? We know he can punch, but he also brings good skills and lightning speed and a very fast starter. The aggressive Luis Maldonado, very tough guy who seldom goes backwards. Doesn't hit as hard, though, as Donaire, which could be a huge factor.
Probably if there's one thing in this match that we would be looking at, it's a question of whether Luis Maldonado can, in fact, make Donaire feel his punches.
Donaire, the champion in the red with the white trim. Maldonado, the challenger in the red and green. Maldonado can take a punch, has lots of heart. However, he is hittable and he cuts, which could also impact tonight. Maldonado, mainly a boxer counterpuncher, good body puncher, will switch to southpaw, usually in round two for some reason.
Like clockwork, he does.
I know. Although Donaire doesn't think he'll switch as much versus a right-hander. We shall see. Interestingly, Donaire's only loss against the southpaw. After that, he quit for a while. His heart wasn't in it, but in time he realized he loved the sport.
Early on here in this match, what we want to see is when Maldonado's attacking Donaire, does he square his body to him and make himself a more available target?
Donaire feels that Maldonado will be easier to hit than Darchinian because he keeps coming forward. Darchinian, as unorthodox as he is, fights more from the outside. As you can see, Donaire, with those high red socks, terrific physical attributes, tall, angular, strong, good reach, factors against Darchinian. Will they impact here tonight? There's that nice jab and a good right hand followed by a left uppercut by Donaire.
Donaire has a complete arsenal, and the hook that knocked Darchinian out was a punch that he wasn't using for a lot of fights because it was injured early in his career, and now it's a weapon for him, and they want to land it in every fight.
Yeah, unexpectedly, it was the telling punch. Most thought the right would be more instrumental.
And there is a good left hook by Donaire.
Donaire had broken his left hand earlier in his career, as you point out, and it had posed problems throughout his career. It was a perfect left hand with uncanny anticipation. I mean, he too is I mentioned Maldonado's a good counterpuncher, but so is Donaire. If you'll recall, Darchinian was just about ready to throw a left hand himself when he got nailed with the left hook by Donaire. And the punch had so much force behind it that Darchinian was completely disoriented, didn't even realize he'd been knocked out.
You know, so far in this match, Donaire has also had the edge in hand speed. His combinations have been much quicker than Maldonado. Now, we know that Donaire is a quick starter, so we kind of expect that.
20 seconds left in the opening round. Scheduled for 12 for the IBF flyweight belt. As mentioned, Maldonado battled Christian Mahares to a draw. No easy feet, although Maharis is southpaw. Some compare Donaire to Maharis because of his size and punching accuracy.
Time!
Mata. Vaseline. John, do your painting. Huh? Paint right, bang. Work on the pan. Don't get too close to him. Just watch for that. Watch for his counter hook. Okay? Don't get careless. Put your hands up all the time. You're wide open.
A very good
okay?
First round for Nonito Donaire, and we talked about the left hook and how it is now an important punch for him. Countering left, just like the one that got to Darchinin, because it was a right hand over the right that Donaire landed it. And by the way, for right at the end of that first round, Maldonado switched lefty, so he beat it by about four seconds.
Well, he did switch to lefty in the first round against Darchinian, which may have actually worked against him, because I thought he was more effective with his straight right.
Bucks.
And he just didn't jab enough in that fight. We'll see how this one goes against the man who conquered Darchinian. You noticed in the corner of Donaire, the man talking to him was his dad, Nonito Donaire Sr. Many father-son teams don't work, but this one does. Good right hand there by Donaire.
I think that Gil Clancy bromide is going to hold true for Nonito Donaire. He's fighting with such confidence already in this match that you can see he believes in himself.
Yeah, there is a concern, of course, when a guy wins in the fashion he did and then has a parade thrown for him in his home area. You know, you start getting a swelled head and all that. But it doesn't seem to be the case here for Donaire. Good right hand by Donaire. Oh, that one really caught him. And Maldonado disoriented. He's in some trouble now as he backpedals. He's got him against the ropes. What a huge right hand to start things off. And there's some bleeding now, Al.
And even as a lefty, Maldonado is having trouble. And you mentioned bleeding, Maldonado, of course, with the history of cutting. So this fight not starting out well for Maldonado at all.
Yeah, there's blood coming down the left side of Maldonado's face. Donaire just missed with a right hand there. What a wicked right hand by Nonito Donaire. And blood immediately started spurting out of the left side of Maldonado's face.
And you know what? Donaire fights lefty so well. He keeps his foot in a position to throw that left hook, and he cranks it up, and there it is. That's a perfect example of it right there, where he counters over the jab of a lefty.
And Nonito is trying to end it in dramatic fashion. The face of Maldonado now a bloody mess. And this is nothing new with him. The blood from Maldonado all over the chest of Donaire. Another left hook upstairs, and Maldonado stumbled momentarily but maintained his balance.
The offensive arsenal of Donaire, very impressive.
And Maldonado in the southpaw stance here. I always feel that when a guy switches to southpaw, he loses something. His offense and defense does suffer.
Yeah, very. Some people can get it done. Maldonado doesn't have much power, does lose it. Good left hook again by Donaire. He has got that punch zeroed in over the jab of Maldonado.
Oh, Nonito Donaire.
And there's another cut over the right eye of Maldonado.
Yeah, things are getting really messy now for the challenger. The blood getting into his eyes. And non-stop pursuit by the champion.
Time!
Maldonado extricates himself from that run. Barely.
Punch. Right here.
Donaire has mixed in some great lead rights like that one that set Maldonado back on his heels. But the left hook has been an impressive weapon as we look at it from above. There's the right hand by Donaire. And later on, the left hook would become a factor. As a lefty now, the right hand very low from Aldonado, and Donaire turns that hook over and does it very effectively.
They cleaned up the mess on the face of Luis Maldonado. Ringside physician Dr. Michael Schwartz was in there, but here's some the bleeding erupts out of the corner of his right eye, even before the next round begins. So he's in difficulty already here to begin round three.
You know, Maldonado came back, as we noted, with four wins after the loss to Dejini, but three were against fighters with records of 10-17, 7-28, and 2-3. Fought Sergio Espinoza, who's 14-3-1 in his last win, and it was a tough win for him. So he may be slipping backwards, and this may be a part of that, although most of what's happening tonight is because Donaire is fighting well.
Yeah, a combination of things. Maldonado, there's a good sweeping right hand that tagged Maldonado on the cheek. Combination of the fan-friendly technique and power style of Nonito Donaire and perhaps bad preparation leading up to this fight for Maldonado.
Donaire, of course, a Showbox alum. Showbox series and went on to win a title as so many boxers have from that series.
And the exciting thing about him, Al, I mean, he's a flyweight with a big frame, so he could really move up to 115, 118, maybe even to featherweight at some point.
Yeah, they certainly can get up to bantamweight. There's no question about that.
Are you talking about a rematch with Darcini at 115, perhaps a fight with, there's a nice right hand by Donaire, fight with Jorge Arce at 118.
And both cuts now reopened on the face of Maldonado. So they're going to have to take a really long look at that to see if there's any way they can stop those cuts and whether this fight should go on. Although the cuts are on the side of the eyes, not over them.
Maldonado's been in some grueling fights, and add this one to the roster.
Yeah.
We approach the final minute of round three. It's scheduled for 12, but will it go that deep?
Donaire said to us, oh,
left hook. Those
hooks. He said he thought cuts would be an issue for Maldonado, and they are.
And he just hammers away with the right. The right, a big factor, as well as the hook for Donaire. Donaire is so focused. And Maldonado, so bloody.
What a difference that left hook has made for him now that he's healthy, his hand is healthy, and he can throw it. It just makes Donaire a complete fighter.
Well, his face is a raging mess, Maldonado, right now. But he's the type of guy that will fight on throughout. It won't stop him. I mean, he's just red-faced. Big swing and a miss by Donaire, looking for the end. 11 of his 18 wins by knockout, Donaire. And he's looking for number 12 tonight.
Hey!
Keep going in this fight.
Yeah. Póntele de zurdo. Póntele de zurdo. Y no te le quedes parado.
Go southpaw on him. Go southpaw.
Él está batallando, no se está acomodando contigo.
Well, as they advise Maldonado to go lefty, we see him there as a right-hander, but that's where he did switch to lefty. And the problem is he's been ineffective from both stances. And when he goes to the left-handed stance, there's the left hook by Donaire. That one missed, but for the most part, they've been landing. So, Steve, righty or lefty, there's no safe haven for this young man.
Famed cutman Jimmy Montoya,
yes,
earning his money tonight. He actually worked with Nonito Donaire in the past for about 3 years. Nonito actually lived in Jimmy's house for a while, so he knows the champion very well. But boy, he's got his work cut out here with the cuts.
Yeah, Jimmy Montoya, really a great boxing guy as a trainer, cutman, manager, and all the rest.
Nonito Donaire, 18-1, 11 knockouts, 6.5-year pro. He's in the red trunks. Luis Maldonado with the more experienced 37-1-1, 28 KOs, a 9-year veteran. IBF number 4, his second world title shot, but it is not going well. Left hook there by Donaire, missing with that left hook.
And how about Donaire switched to lefty momentarily? And there he is now again,
yes,
becoming a lefty. Now that's perplexing to me, because you can't be doing better than you are in the right-handed stance than Donaire is. So this to me is a really questionable tactic.
We'll have to find out why he did that. Now he switches back to conventional. And meanwhile, Maldonado is in the lefty stance.
It'd be like one of Woody Hayes' old teams deciding to throw the ball on every down after they were getting first down after first down.
Yeah, it didn't make much sense. Yeah.
I date myself by saying Woody Hayes. I could have picked some contemporary. There's a nice jab by Maldonado getting in.
You're just showing your depth.
That's it. Nice right hook by Maldonado. And there's, in the keys, I said Donaire can't throw wild punches. That's exactly what he did there. And he got hit with a really good right hook by Maldonado. Did that punch make a difference? And look at Maldonado come back.
Luis Maldonado showing a lot of mettle. That's no surprise. Able to score here from the southpaw stance. And suddenly, Donaire becoming a bit more cautious for the first time in this particular contest.
Wow, that was interesting. I mean, Maldonado has done pretty well in this round. Might even be winning it.
Donaire, just for the record, never down, pro or amateur. He was stunned only once versus Jose Cardenas, July 06. But Donaire took a second round TKO there. And here's another left hand, a straight left that scored by Maldonado.
Maldonado's having a really good round. That was kind of a push.
Yeah, that was a balance situation for Maldonado. Much better round for Maldonado. And also the good news, not bleeding, except for a little bit from the right eye. And it's going around the eye socket.
You gotta keep going. Don't open up. Don't open up. Don't put your head inside.
What a turnaround in that fourth round. Luis Maldonado, who looked completely out of this fight, will land a big right hook. That's the first of what was a number of good punches that he landed. Not just the right hook, but also some very good straight left hands. And later on in the round, he would keep the pressure up, using his jab as a range finder. There was a nice left hook by Donaire, he got kind of pushed backward. But it was in a round in which Luis Maldonado got on the scoreboard by winning one.
Hey, so Donaire's got to be careful. Al, he can't get too cute. He has dominated the first 3-plus rounds, and then all of a sudden, Maldonado got his wake-up call, and, for some reason, Donaire went into a southpaw stance, which seemed to be uncalled for at the time. He was dominating in an orthodox stance.
Inexplicable. And, this reminds us that Maldonado has been ranked in the top 10 in a couple of organizations regularly. That draw with Christian Mahares, who's a very, very good fighter, it's not an aberration. He is a good fighter, Luis Maldonado.
Well, that was a great accomplishment. Right to the top of the head there with the right hand by Donaire that skipped the challenger back.
It's been a little harder for Donaire to land those straight rights and the left hooks.
They just can't stop that bleeding around the right eye of Maldonado. They pretty much have the rest of it under control, which is an accomplishment.
Jimmy Montoya earning his money working on those cuts, that's for sure.
Ron Borges from ESPN.com. Keith Idick, Herald News, and The Record in New Jersey. Jack Obermeyer, Boxing Digest. They have it all for Donaire.
I've got Donaire winning 39-36. Vamos, meter las pernas para que pueda meter su gancho. For 37, I'm sorry.
Midway through the fifth, it's scheduled for 12 for the IBF flyweight title. I mean, earlier, Maldonado's face was just drenched in blood. It was a pool of blood. And now it's just, at least it's limited to just the right side of his face.
You know,
thank goodness for small favors.
Nonito Donaire has been much more tentative.
Ooh, nice body shot by Donaire.
Great shot downstairs in the last round or two.
Donaire missing a lot more now. Twice there, and that one was blocked. Those last two blocked by Maldonado. Maldonado gaining in confidence despite the way his face looks. There's a straight left hand that scored by Maldonado. He's got Donaire backing up, but as he was backing up, a nice left hook by Donaire.
Donaire will always be looking for that counter left hook. And he's come back in this round with some big shots, and there's the hook again.
Yeah, Donaire is just surgically picking Maldonado apart in the last minute with very fast hands, luring speed. Maldonado missing, throwing from too far out because he's felt the power of Donaire. Good left hand there by Maldonado, right on the nose.
His dad urging him to throw the body, and there is Donaire with a great right hand downstairs. Maldonado, while I don't think he won that round, did have his moments. Lands a good straight left hand from the southpaw stance.
David Zayas, one of the stars of the critically acclaimed series Dexter here on Showtime.
And they've seen some blood on that show as well, I think, haven't they? But maybe more sometimes than we're even seeing from the face of Maldonado.
Round six scheduled for 12 for the IBF flyweight championship. Nonito Donaire, the champion of the red with the white trim. Luis Maldonado, ranked number four, the challenger on the green and red and white.
Keep him up, keep him up, come on.
A right hand early on by Donaire opened up the cut around the left eye of Maldonado. Then the right side started to get bloodied, and they've got part of it under control, but it continues to bleed from the left eye.
There again is the left hook. Whenever Maldonado comes in with his right jab and lunges, or even with his left hand, he gets nailed with that counter left hook by Nonito Donaire.
And you got to like a guy who listens to his father. Nonito Donaire going to the body, like Dad said.
Yeah, he's good body puncher, Donaire.
Very good.
Donaire has been 12 rounds, one time beat Oscar Andrade in that match. Maldonado is 1-0-1. He's won a match and had that draw with Maharis over 12 rounds. So as we head into these middle and later rounds, that's something to think about.
Donaire pinning Maldonado against the ropes. That's not where you want to be if you're Maldonado.
We're seeing a real lesson in how resilient Luis Maldonado is. How can anyone have a worse opening three rounds than he did? And yet here he is in the middle of this fight, while probably not winning these rounds, at least being somewhat competitive.
Yeah, Donaire was in complete and utter control in the early going, and then all of a sudden Maldonado started to come back a little bit.
Donaire with the counter right.
Oh, he's now letting his hands go, Donaire. Nice left-right combination upstairs. Drilled him again with the right hand. Goes downstairs to the body. That was a little low, though.
Yeah, now Donaire has to be careful. He's throwing rights to the body and also throwing uppercuts from way out. And Maldonado's trying to counter him with his left. That could be a dangerous thing for Donaire to do.
Oh, straight right hand right on the nose by Donaire. That shook Maldonado up momentarily, but he comes firing back. Tough kid, Maldonado. And he's scored. Continues to come forward. Talk about guts.
One round at a time. Come on, DJ, 7 pounds. Siete rounds, come on.
Let's go, you gotta keep going. That's how we're gonna get him. You're going, listen to me, and you're gonna win. Don't let him keep going at you. Hit him back.
Keep that right hand going.
Well, Donaire has landed lots of left hooks, but that was one of the lead right hands that he was able to get in. There's the uppercut from the outside by Donaire, and then a right hand. He gets nailed by Maldonado. So sometimes Nonito Donaire getting his right hand low for a variety of reasons of getting nailed. But clearly a round Donaire won, but an exciting one nonetheless.
And we had a round 7. Who thought it would go this far after the way it started? Maldonado, the kind of fighter that just doesn't back down.
You know, you ask yourself, if Luis Maldonado was just a little more powerful, you know, when he's been in, we saw him against Arcinian, we mentioned the Maharis fight, here he is against Donaire. In his big test, it's not as if he can't land some punches, he's just not a big hitter.
And he took some punishing, I mean, really wretched shots from Arcinian. He's taken a few here, too.
Oh boy, is he ever.
And he comes back even stronger. Afterwards.
Yeah, the left hand of Maldonado now getting in from time to time. But, and you know, Donaire will be tested. And as we look at the press row score,
Donaire in charge.
I have it 59-55 for Donaire.
Donaire on the march.
Santiago is going to face Antonio Tarver, a lefty. And Santiago has good double left hooks. He could be watching Nonito Donaire land those left hooks and pick up a few things against about how to deal with the left.
That'll be our second co-main event later tonight. In between, you'll see Vernon Forrest and Michele Picciarillo for the WBC Super Welterweight Championship.
Nice counter right hand by Nonito Donaire. He is a very skilled and well-polished fighter.
His brother Glenn Donaire is not here. He's getting ready for a fight himself. Good right hand there by Nonito. Glenn also fought Victor Arcinian. Arcinian broke his jaw, broke Donaire's jaw in that fight, and Nonito able to avenge his brother's defeat.
And his brother really more of a junior fly, so that was kind of moving up in weight for him.
Yeah, Nonito physically bigger, different kind of a fighter than Glenn. Nonito more technical. There's a nice left hook to the chin.
Well, if there was any part of Nonito's Donaire's preparation for this fight that he did skimp on because of all the trip to the Philippines and all the rest going on, we're going to find out, maybe, because Maldonado may take him the distance here. So far, we don't see any evidence of it. Donaire has been excellent.
Yeah, he's won just about every round, and he has rocked Maldonado. There's another big shot by Donaire, and the sweeping left puts Maldonado down. Down for only the second time in his career.
7, 8.
Well, he got up, though, like a rocket. And it was at the end of the round, fortunately, for Maldonado.
Sit down. You're okay. You're okay. Sit down and relax. How are you feeling? You're feeling okay? You want more? You want to go out there?
Well, Nonito Donaire dramatically ends that round. A big uppercut. That's the one that started the problem for Maldonado. And then this left hook sends him to the canvas. Great uppercut on the inside by Donaire that froze Maldonado. There it is. Look at him. He's just got froze right there and then got hit with the big left hook by Nonito Donaire.
They want the ringside physician to check Maldonado out.
Okay.
Hey,
Luis, no hay mañana, Luis.
And they say fight on. Somebody asked Maldonado in the corner, you want to continue? What did you expect him to say? I mean, after what we've seen in his career, not only tonight, we've seen him a number of times. He never quits. He has no quit.
Really, just a gritty performer. Donaire, I think, wants to go out there and get him out in this round. I feel the resolve that he would like to end this fight.
The only other time Maldonado went down was back in June 06 against, guess who? There's a running theme here, Victor Arcinian. It was round six, and it was a straight left. This was more of a left hook.
And you know what's interesting? If Victor Arcinian is sitting and watching this bout, which he might be, one of the things that might give him a little, nice right by Donaire, a little cause for optimism is the amount of straight lefts that Maldonado has landed.
He wants to end it. Donaire. Here's a barrage by Donaire. The referee looking very closely, but he lets it go on. As Donaire just let up momentarily. Charlie Dwyer right on top of the situation, third man of the ring. Donaire looking to end it in dramatic fashion.
Keep up.
Oh, belting him to the body with the left, and that is it. Nonito Donaire scores a TKO in round eight.
Good job by Charlie Dwyer stepping in at that moment. He gave it every opportunity, and then enough was enough.
And as gutty and gritty as Maldonado is, no argument. I overheard Nonito Donaire say he hurt his hand back in the second round.
What was that, seven or eight? Eight. Damn, almost touching it. That was close. No, if I didn't have
I guess
hand.
He wanted a seventh round KO. Got it in the eighth.
Well, Nonito Donaire didn't knock him out earlier than Darchinian, but he got the knockout. We'll look at the right hand in the last round that started the problem. Perfect straight right hand through the guard. And then Donaire knew that if he could just throw enough punches, he might get this fight stopped, and he blasted away. Charlie Dwyer did a very good job of letting this fight go to the point where he gave Maldonado a chance at least, but then was able to step in just at the moment where this fighter was in trouble. Good job by referee and for Maldonado. Enough. And what else? The left hook was the punctuating punch. And why not? It's been such an important one during the course of this fight for Donaire. That actually a half left hook, half uppercut. But Nonito Donaire, you said it before the fight. You said he wanted to show he wasn't a one-punch wonder. A lot more than that.
Good stoppage by Charlie Dwyer. And we're set now for the official time. Let's get it up to our ring announcer, Jimmy Lennon Jr.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have the time of 1 minute 16 seconds in round number 8. A referee in charge, Charlie Dwyer, stops the contest. He is the winner by way of technical knockout. He is still the IBF and IBO flyweight champion of the world, the Filipino Flash, Nonito Donaire.
So his fans celebrate. The dream ride continues for Nonito Donaire. Holds on to the IBF flyweight belt. His first successful defense. Will we see a Donaire-Darchinian rematch? Darchinian has certainly called out for it. Possible fight with Jorge Arce. Filipino flash, Nonito Donaire moves on. Well, this being our final installment of America's Fight Night for 2007, tonight's text message question looks ahead to the upcoming year. Which one of these fights are you most looking forward to? We invite you to text your choice to SHOTV. That's 74688. For Vasquez versus Peter, text 1. For Vasquez versus Marquez, 3. Text 2. And for Tarver versus Dawson, text 3. We'll bring you the results later on in the telecast. Standard text messaging rates apply.
Do I get the vote?
We're ready for post-fight comments, so let's go up to the ring and Jim Gray.
All right, Steve, thank you very much. Nonito, congratulations to you on your first title defense. Did you hurt your hand early in the fight?
Well, you know, I've always had that problem, so, you know, but it's okay. You know, I got the victory. But one thing that bothered me most was my legs. I could not move. That's why I felt so sluggish. I didn't have my legs today, you know, and that's why I relied on my power most of the time.
Back to the hand. Is that the reason you haven't taken off the glove?
It's okay. Like I said, it's okay. You know, I've had the problem before. You know, every fighter has it, but it's good. It's good.
You decided in the fourth round to switch and become a southpaw fighter. What made you make that decision when things were going so well?
He was kind of awkward when, you know, I'm used to fighting lefty, but he was just, you know, I guess I had my D'Artagnan lefty style, so it was weird to see him fight like that. I could not counter him with my uppercut, and every time I tried to come up with the right, he already blocked it, so I was trying to just, like I said, if I had my legs, it would have been a lot easier, but I couldn't move, so I relied most of my body movement, upper body movement, and I just try to counter him as much as I can. And, you know, just the awkwardness of his lefty. I mean, he wasn't awkward, but he was a lot defensive because he had a longer arm, so I couldn't really get through my uppercuts and hooks with him.
And he was very courageous as well, as we take a look at the end of the fight here. Did you ever feel that you were in peril, or did you know once you bloodied his eyes and once you controlled that it wasn't going to be a problem?
I know he was a tough fighter. You know, I didn't doubt him. You know, I mean, I respect him a lot. He is a great fighter. You know, he was tough. Because, see, look, I hit him with that good uppercut, and that was right in the button, you know. And, you know, he has a lot of courage, and I respect him a lot for that. And he gave me a hell of a fight, you know.
And what now? What would you like to do now, Nonito?
My promoter is here. You know, he got me this fight. He made me who I am today. And, you know, I mean, I guess my validation was today, although I didn't feel 100% because, like, you know, my legs was in there, my whole body was in there. But, you know, whatever's next, I'm up for it. I'm a fighter, and that's all I know. I'm sorry. I'm running out of breath.
It's okay. I know they're celebrating back in the Philippines. Quickly, Gary, do you have another opponent in mind?
No, not necessarily. We want to unify. Nonito wants to be the first Filipino to...
I want to do that first. I mean, I know Pacquiao and everybody else. You know, I respect them a lot. They're so great. You know, I'm happy for my country. We have a fourth world champion now. And you know, that's one thing I want to do before everybody else does. You know, it's a record. It's something that I've always looked for ever since I was young.
Congratulations. I'm sure there'll be another parade, and enjoy your time at the Presidential Palace again.
Thank you so much. I would like to thank Arthur, Ala Jim, and everybody in the Philippines. Thank you so much. I love you guys. I'm just so thankful for it. And Showtime, thank you so much.
Thanks, Jim.
And congratulations to you. All right, Steve, back to you.
Thank you very much, Jim. The very good-natured Nonito Donaire, good-natured and skilled in the ring, beats a very brave Luis Maldonado. We'll see how...
It's interesting. I mean, Maldonado has done pretty well in this round. Might even be winning it.
Donaire, just for the record, never down, pro or amateur. He was stunned only once versus Jose Cardenas, July 06. But Donaire took a second round TKO there. And here's another left hand, a straight left that scored by Maldonado.
Maldonado's having a really good round. That was kind of a push.
Yeah, that was a balance situation for Maldonado. Much better round for Maldonado. And also the good news, not bleeding, except for a little bit from the right arm. And it's going around the eye socket.
Cut him off. He's running around.
He's
running around.
How you doing?
That's right.
You doing all right?
Doing good.
Fine. You doing all right?
A
You got to keep calling. You got to keep calling. Don't open up. Don't open up. Don't put your head inside.
What a turnaround in that fourth round. Luis Maldonado, who looked completely out of this fight, will land a big right hook. That's the first of what was a number of good punches that he landed. Not just the right hook, but also some very good straight left hands. And later on in the round, he would keep the pressure up, using his jab as a range finder. There was a nice left hook by Donaire,
and he got
kind of pushed backward. But it was in a round in which Luis Maldonado got on the scoreboard by winning one.
Hey, so Donaire's got to be careful. Al, he can't get too cute. Okay. He has dominated the first three plus rounds, and then all of a sudden Maldonado got his wake-up call, and for some reason Donaire went into a southpaw stance, which seemed to be uncalled for at the time. He was dominating in an orthodox stance.
Inexplicable. And this reminds us that Maldonado has been ranked in the top 10 in a couple of organizations regularly. That draw with Christian Mahares, who's a very, very good fighter, it's not an aberration. He is a good fighter, Luis Maldonado.
Well, that was a great accomplishment. Right to the top of the head there with the right hand by Donaire that skipped the challenger back.
It's been a little harder for Donaire to land those straight rights and the left hooks.
They just can't stop that bleeding around the right eye of Maldonado. They pretty much have the rest of it under control, which is an accomplishment.
Jimmy Montoya earning his money working on those cuts, that's for sure.
Ron Borges from ESPN.com. Keith Idick, Herald News, and The Record in New Jersey. Jack Obermeyer, Boxing Digest. They have it all for Donaire.
I've got Donaire winning 39-36. Or 37, I'm sorry.
Midway through the fifth, it's scheduled for 12 for the IBF flyweight title. I mean, earlier, Maldonado's face was just drenched in blood. It was a pool of blood. And now it's just, at least it's limited to just the right side of his face. Thank goodness for small favors.
Nonito Donaire has been much more tentative.
Ooh, nice body shot by Donaire.
Great shot downstairs in the last round or two.
Donaire missing a lot more now. Twice there, and that one was blocked. Those last two blocked by Maldonado. Maldonado gaining in confidence despite the way his face looks. There's a straight left hand that scored by Maldonado. He's got Donaire backing up. But as he was backing up, a nice left hook by Donaire.
Donaire will always be looking for that counter left hook. And he's come back in this round with some big shots, and there's the hook again.
Yeah, Donaire is just surgically picking Maldonado apart in the last minute with very fast hands. Luring speed. Maldonado missing, throwing from too far out, because he's felt the power of Donaire. Good left hand there by Maldonado, right on the nose.
His dad urging him to throw the body, and there is Donaire with a great right hand downstairs. Maldonado, while I don't think he won that round, did have his moments. Lands a good straight left hand from the southpaw stance.
David Zayas, one of the stars of the critically acclaimed series Dexter here on Showtime.
And they've seen some blood on that show as well, I think, haven't they? but maybe more sometimes than we're even seeing from the face of Maldonado.
Round six, scheduled for 12 for the IBF Flyweight Championship. Nonito Donaire, the champion of the red with the white trim. Luis Maldonado, ranked number four, the challenger on the green and red and white.
Keep him up, keep him up, come on.
A right hand early on by Donaire opened up the cut around the left eye of Maldonado. Then the right side started to get bloodied, and they've got part of it under control, but it continues to bleed from the left eye.
There again is the left hook. Whenever Maldonado comes in with his right jab and lunges, or even with his left hand, he gets nailed with that counter left hook by Nonito Donaire.
And you gotta like a guy who listens to his father. Nonito Donaire going to the body, like Dad said.
Yeah, he's a good body puncher, Donaire.
Very good.
Donaire has been 12 rounds one time, beat Oscar Andrade in that match. Maldonado is 1-0-1. He's won a match and had that draw with Maharis over 12 rounds. So as we head into these middle and later rounds, that's something to think about.
Donaire pinning Maldonado against the ropes. That's not where you want to be if you're Maldonado.
We're seeing a real lesson in how resilient Luis Maldonado is. How can anyone have a worse opening three rounds than he did? And yet here he is in the middle of this fight, while probably not winning these rounds, at least being somewhat competitive.
Yeah, Donaire was in complete and utter control in the early going, and then all of a sudden Maldonado started to come back a little bit.
Donaire with the counter right.
Oh, he's now letting his hands go, Donaire. Nice left-right combination upstairs. Drilled him again with the right hand. Goes downstairs to the body. That was a little low, though.
Yeah, now Donaire has to be careful. He's throwing rights to the body and also throwing uppercuts from way out. And Maldonado's trying to counter him with his left. That could be a dangerous thing for Donaire to do.
Oh, straight right hand right on the nose by Donaire. That shook Maldonado up momentarily, but he comes firing back. Tough kid, Maldonado. And he's scoring. It was almost like a wake-up call for Maldonado. He got better after he got drilled. And he continues to come forward. Talk about guts.
Let's go. You got to keep going. That's how we're going to get him. You're going, listen to me, and you're going to win. Don't let him keep going at you. Hit him back. Keep that right hand going.
Well, Donaire has landed lots of left hooks, but that was one of the lead right hands that he was able to get in. There's the uppercut from the outside by Donaire, and then a right hand. He gets nailed by Maldonado. So sometimes Nonito Donaire getting his right hand low for a variety of reasons of getting nailed. But clearly a round Donaire won, but an exciting one nonetheless.
And we had a round seven. Who thought it would go this far after the way it started? Maldonado, the kind of fighter that just doesn't back down.
You know, you ask yourself, if Luis Maldonado was just a little more powerful, you know, when he's been in, we saw him against Arcinian, we mentioned the Maharis fight, here he is against Donaire. In his big test, it's not as if he can't land some punches, he's just not a big hitter.
And he took some punishing, I mean, really wretched shots from Arcinian. He's taken a few here, too.
Oh boy, is he ever.
And he comes back even stronger afterwards.
Yeah, the left hand of Maldonado now getting in from time to time. But, and you know, Donaire will be tested. And as we look at the press row scoring,
Donaire in charge.
I have it 59-55 for
Donaire. Donaire on the march.
You know, later on, Danny Santiago is going to face Antonio Tarver, a lefty. And Santiago has good double left hooks. He could be watching Nonito Donaire land those left hooks and pick up a few things against about how to deal with the left.
That'll be our second co-main event later tonight. In between, you'll see Vernon Forrest and Michele Piccirillo for the WBC Super Welterweight Championship.
Nice counter right hand by Nonito Donaire. He is a very skilled and well-polished fighter.
His brother Glenn Donaire is not here. He's getting ready for a fight himself. Good right hand there by Nonito. Glenn also fought Vic Darchinian. Darchinian broke his jaw, broke Donaire's jaw in that fight, and Nonito able to avenge his brother's defeat.
And his brother really more of a junior fly, so that was kind of moving up in weight for him.
Yeah, Nonito physically bigger, different kind of a fighter than Glenn. Nonito more technical. There's a nice left hook to the chin.
Well, if there was any part of Nonito Donaire's preparation for this fight that he did skimp on because of all the trip to the Philippines and all the rest going on, we're going to find out, maybe, because Maldonado may take him the distance here. So far, we don't see any evidence of it. Donaire has been excellent.
Yeah, he's won just about every round, and he has rocked Maldonado. There's another big shot by Donaire, and the sweeping left puts Maldonado down.
Four,
down for only the second time in his career.
Seven, eight.
Well, he got up, though, like a rocket. And it was at the end of the round, fortunately, for Maldonado.
Sit down. You're okay. You're okay. Sit down and relax. How are you feeling? You're feeling okay? You want more? You want to go out there?
Well, Nonito Donaire dramatically ends that round. A big uppercut. That's the one that started the problem for Maldonado. And then this left hook sends him to the canvas. Great uppercut on the inside by Donaire that froze Maldonado. There it is. Look at him. He's just got froze right there and then got hit with the big left hook by Nonito Donaire. Donaire has mixed in some great lead rights like that one that set Maldonado back on his heels. But the left hook has been an impressive weapon as we look at it from above. There's the right hand by Donaire. And later on, the left hook would become a factor. As a lefty now, the right hand very low from Maldonado, and Donaire turns that hook over and does it very effectively.
They cleaned up the mess on the face of Luis Maldonado. Ringside physician Dr. Michael Schwartz was in there, but here's some the bleeding. Erupts out of the corner of his right eye even before the next round begins. So he's in difficulty already here to begin round three.
You know, Maldonado came back, as we noted, with four wins after the loss to Darchinian, but three were against fighters with records of 10-17, 7-28, and 2-3. Fought Sergio Espinoza, who's 14-3-1 in his last win, and it was a tough win for him. So he may be slipping backwards, and this may be a part of that, although most of what's happening tonight is because Donaire is fighting well.
Yeah, a combination of things. Maldonado, there's a good sweeping right hand that tagged Maldonado on the cheek. Combination of the fan-friendly technique and power style of Nonito Donaire and perhaps bad preparation leading up to this fight for Maldonado.
Donaire, of course, a Showbox alum. Showbox series, and went on to win a title, as so many boxers have from that series.
And the exciting thing about him, Al, I mean, he's a flyweight with a big frame, so he could really move up to 115, 118, maybe even to featherweight at some point.
Yeah, they certainly can get up to bantamweight. There's no question about that.
Are we talking about a rematch with Darchini at 115, perhaps a fight with, there's a nice right hand by Donaire, fight with Jorge Arce at 118.
And both cuts now reopened on the face of Maldonado. So they're going to have to take a really long look at that to see if there's any way they can stop those cuts and whether this fight should go on. Although the cuts are on the side of the eyes, not over them.
Maldonado's been in some grueling fights, and add this one to the roster.
Yeah.
We approach the final minute of round three. It's scheduled for 12, but will it go that deep?
Donaire said to us, hooks. He said he thought cuts would be an issue for Maldonado, and they are.
And he just hammers away with the right. The right, a big factor, as well as the hook for Donaire. Donaire is so focused. And Maldonado so bloody.
What a difference that left hook has made for him now that he's healthy, his hand is healthy, and he can throw it. It just makes Donaire a complete fighter.
Well, his face is a raging mess, Maldonado, right now. But he's the type of guy that will fight on throughout. It won't stop him. But he's just red-faced. Big swing and a miss by Donaire, looking for the end. 11 of his 18 wins by knockout, Donaire. And he's looking for number 12 tonight.
Hey!
Keep going in this fight.
Yeah. Póntele de zurdo. Póntele de zurdo. Y no te le quedes parado.
Go southpaw on
him.
Well, as they advise Maldonado to go lefty, we see him there as a right-hander, but that's where he did switch to lefty. And the problem is he's been ineffective from both stances. And when he goes to the left-handed stance, there's the left hook by Donaire. That one missed, but for the most part, they've been landing. So, Steve, righty or lefty, there's no safe haven for this young man.
Famed cutman Jimmy Montoya,
yes,
earning his money tonight. He actually worked with Nonito Donaire in the past for about 3 years. Nonito actually lived in Jimmy's house for a while, so he knows the champion very well. But boy, he's got his work cut out here with the cuts.
Yeah, Jimmy Montoya, really a great boxing guy as a trainer, cut man, manager, and all the rest.
Nonito Donaire, 18-1, 11 knockouts, 6.5-year pro. He's in the red trunks. Luis Maldonado with the more experience, 37-1-1, 28 KOs, a 9-year veteran. IBF number 4, his second world title shot, but it is not going well. Left hook there by Donaire, missing with that left hook.
And how about Donaire switch to lefty momentarily? And there he is now again,
yes,
becoming a lefty. Now that's perplexing to me, because you can't be doing better than you are in the right-handed stance than Donaire is. So this to me is a really questionable tactic.
We'll have to find out why he did that. Now he switches back to conventional. And meanwhile, Maldonado is in the lefty stance.
It'd be like one of Woody Hayes' old teams deciding to throw the ball on every down after they were getting first down after first down.
Yeah, it didn't make much sense. Yeah.
I date myself by saying Woody Hayes. I could have picked some contemporary. There's a nice jab by Maldonado getting it.
You're just showing your depth.
That's it. nice right hook by Maldonado. And there's, in the keys, I said Donaire can't throw wild punches. That's exactly what he did there. And he got hit with a really good right hook by Maldonado. Did that punch make a difference? And look at Maldonado come back.
Luis Maldonado showing a lot of metal. That's no surprise. Able to score here from the southpaw stance. And suddenly Donaire becoming a bit more cautious for the first time in this particular contest. Maldonado can take a punch, has lots of heart. However, he is hittable and he cuts, which could also impact tonight. Maldonado, mainly a boxer counterpuncher, good body puncher, will switch to southpaw, usually in round two for some reason.
Like clockwork, he does.
I know. Although Donaire doesn't think he'll switch as much versus a right-hander. We shall see. Interestingly, Donaire's only loss against the southpaw. After that, he quit for a while. His heart wasn't in it, but in time he realized he loved the sport.
Early on here in this match, what we want to see is when Maldonado's attacking Donaire, does he square his body to him and make himself a more available target?
Donaire feels that Maldonado will be easier to hit than Darchinian because he keeps coming forward. Darchinian, as unorthodox as he is, fights more from the outside. As you can see, Donaire, with those high red socks, terrific physical attributes, tall, angular, strong, good reach, factors against Darchinian. Will they impact here tonight? There's that nice jab and a good right hand followed by a left uppercut by Donaire.
Donaire has a complete arsenal, and the hook that knocked Darchinian out was a punch that he wasn't using for a lot of fights because it was injured early in his career, and now it's a weapon for him, and they want to land it in every fight.
Yeah, unexpectedly, it was the telling punch. Most thought the right would be more instrumental.
And there is a good left hook by Donaire.
Donaire had broken his left hand earlier in his career, as you point out, and it had posed problems throughout his career. It was a perfect left hand with uncanny anticipation. I mean, he too is, I mentioned Maldonado is a good counterpuncher, but so is Donaire. If you'll recall, Darchinian was just about ready to throw a left hand himself when he got nailed with the left hook by Donaire. And the punch had so much force behind it that Darchinian was completely disoriented, didn't even realize he'd been knocked out.
You know, so far in this match, Donaire has also had the edge in hand speed. His combinations have been much quicker than Maldonado. Now, we know that Donaire is a quick starter, so we kind of expect that.
20 seconds left in the opening round. Scheduled for 12 for the IBF flyweight belt. As mentioned, Maldonado battled Christian Mijares to a draw. No easy feat, although Mijares is southpaw. Some compare Donaire to Mijares because of his size and punching accuracy.
Huh? Mata. Vaseline, Vaseline. John, do your painting. Huh? Paint right, bang. Work my mechanic. Don't get too close to him. Just watch for that. Watch for his counter hook. Okay? Don't get careless. Put your hands up all the time.
A very good first round for Nonito Donaire, and we talked about the left hook and how it is now an important punch for him. Countering left, just like the one that got to Darchinian, because it was a right hand over the right that Donaire landed it. And by the way, for right at the end of that first round, Maldonado switched to lefty, so he beat it by about four seconds.
Well, he did switch to lefty in the first round against Darchinian, which may have actually worked against him, because I thought he was more effective with his straight right.
Bucks.
And he just didn't jab enough in that fight. We'll see how this one goes against the man who conquered Darchinian. You noticed in the corner of Donaire, the man talking to him was his dad, Nonito Donaire Sr. Many father-son teams don't work, but this one does. Good right hand there by Donaire.
I think that Gil Clancy bromide is going to hold true for Nonito Donaire. He's fighting with such confidence already in this match that you can see he believes in himself.
Yeah, there is a concern, of course, when a guy wins in the fashion he did and then has a parade thrown for him in his home area. You know, you start getting a swelled head and all that. It doesn't seem to be the case here for Donaire. Good right hand by Donaire. Oh, that one really caught him. And Maldonado disoriented. He's in some trouble now as he backpedals. He's got him against the ropes. What a huge right hand to start things off. And there's some bleeding now, Al.
And even as a lefty, Maldonado is having trouble. And you mentioned bleeding, Maldonado, of course, with the history of cutting. So this fight not starting out well for Maldonado at all.
Yeah, there's blood coming down the left side of Maldonado's face. Donaire just missed with a right hand there. What a wicked right hand by Nonito Donaire. And blood immediately started spurting out of the left side of Maldonado's face.
And you know what? Donaire fights lefties so well. He keeps his foot in a position to throw that left hook, and he cranks it up, and there it is. That's a perfect example of it right there, where he counters over the jab of a lefty.
And Nonito is trying to end it in dramatic fashion. The face of Maldonado now a bloody mess. And this is nothing new with him. The blood from Maldonado all over the chest of Donaire. Another left hook upstairs, and Maldonado stumbled momentarily but maintained his balance.
The offensive arsenal of Donaire, very impressive.
And Maldonado in a southpaw stance here. I always feel that when a guy switches to southpaw, he loses something. His offense and defense does suffer.
Yeah, very. Some people can get it done. Maldonado doesn't have much power, does lose it. Good left hook again by Donaire. He has got that punch zeroed in over the jab of Maldonado.
Oh, Nonito Donaire.
And there's another cut over the right eye of Maldonado.
Yeah, things are getting really messy now for the challenger. The blood getting into his eyes. And non-stop pursuit by the champion.
Hey!
Maldonado extricates himself from that run. Barely.
Punch. Right here.
In 39 fights, also impressive, he fought current WBC super flyweight champion Christian Mijares to a draw. Maldonado 4-0 with three knockouts since the loss to Darchinian, although limited opposition. Yet, Al, this a gritty, battle-tested nine-year pro who shouldn't be taken lightly.
In the dictionary, next to solid pro is definitely his picture. And what's more, he has a complete bag of tricks that he brings into this fight. We talked about the switching. He is a very solid fighter, and any letdown by Donaire will not serve him well.
Maldonado, one of nine children, his father a laborer in the fields, and up until recently, about 8 months ago, in fact, Luis was a waiter and a busboy at a restaurant in Mexicali to help support his wife and four-year-old daughter, but now he is 100% devoted to the sport of boxing. They call him the Filipino Flash, the very affable, calm, composed Nonito Donaire, who returns to the same state in which he dethroned previously unbeaten and seemingly impenetrable Victor Darchinian in stunning fashion, the explosive left hook in round five. Donaire coming from virtually nowhere tonight. This young man wants to prove that he is truly an emerging presence, Al, that his performance in July was indeed no fluke, and that he is by no means a one-hit wonder.
You know, the great boxing trainer and commentator Gil Clancy often said that most fighters, when they win a championship, improve by about 20%. But there is also the matter in Donaire to consider that trip that they referred to where he went to the Philippines. Maybe some people think that all that adulation could be a distraction for him.
And in that whirlwind tour, he was honored, as he talked about with Jim Gray, by a big parade in the Philippines, feted by government officials and fans, even met with the Filipino president, as you heard him talking about so glowingly. But now it's back to business. He looks to extend his win streak to 18 in a row, has not lost since 01 in his second professional fight. Let's check the numbers as we go to the tail of the tape here at Foxwoods. Donaire turned 25 just 2 weeks ago, 4 years younger than Maldonado, the champion with the slight edge in height and reach. And at yesterday's weigh-in, both came in under the 112-pound limit by 1 pound. And the key unified rules, there's no standing eight count, no three knockdown rule. A fighter can't be saved by the bell in any round. If an accidental headbutt causes a fight to end within four, it's a no decision. After four rounds, they go to the cards. If a punch causes a cut, the injured fighter cannot continue. He loses by TKO. So here at Foxwoods in Connecticut, we are getting ready for Nonito Donaire versus Luis Maldonado for the IBF Flyweight Championship. Let's get the formal introductions from our ring announcer, Jimmy Lennon Jr.
Ladies and gentlemen, a very good evening to you and welcome to Foxwoods Resort and Casino here in Mashantucket, Connecticut, as we have a big night of action in store for you. And at this time, we present the first of our world title attractions, and it's all brought to you by Gary Shaw Productions in association with Foxwoods and Showtime. This bout coming away is sanctioned by the IBF, President Marion Mohammed, Supervisor Daryl Peoples, and the IBO, President Ed Levine, Supervisor Dr. Jason Levine, along with the Mashantucket Pequot Athletic Commission. Introducing our three judges scoring this bout from ringside, from Providence, Rhode Island, Clark Sammartino, from West Hartford, Connecticut, George Smith, and from Litchfield, Connecticut, Don Trella. And introducing our third man of the ring, the referee in charge of this bout, Charlie Dwyer. All right, fans, here we go. 12 rounds of boxing for the IBF Flyweight Championship of the World. Introducing to you first the challenger. On my right, he is fighting out of the blue corner, wearing red, white, and green trunks. He hails from Mexicali, Baja California, Mexico. He weighed in at 111 pounds with a record of 37 wins, one defeat, and one draw. He has 28 wins coming by way of knockout. Tonight he is making his second attempt at a world title. He is currently ranked number four in the world by the IBF. Please welcome the challenger, Luis Titi Maldonado. Opponent across the ring on my left, the defending world champion, fighting out of the red corner, wearing red trunks with white trim, fighting out of San Leandro, California, by way of General Santos City in the Philippines. He weighed in the same as his opponent, 111 pounds. His record, 18 wins, one defeat, 11 wins coming by way of knockout. Tonight, ladies and gentlemen, he is making the first defense of his title. Please welcome the IBF Flyweight Champion of the World, known as the Filipino Flash, introducing Nonito Donaire. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, 12 rounds of boxing scheduled. Our referee in charge now to give instructions, Charlie Dwyer.
Gentlemen, you both know the rules. Let's have a good, clean fight. Obey my commands at all times. Shake hands. Good luck. Buena suerte.
We get our triple header underway with the IBF Flyweight Championship. Can Nonito Donaire build on his stirring win just 5 months ago? We know he can punch, but he also brings good skills and lightning speed and a very fast starter. The aggressive Luis Maldonado, very tough guy who seldom goes backwards. Doesn't hit as hard, though, as Donaire, which could be a huge factor.
Probably if there's one thing in this match that we would be looking at, it's a question of whether Luis Maldonado can, in fact, make Donaire feel his punches.
Donaire, the champion in the red with the white trim. Maldonado, the challenger in the red and green.